Hey guys, how's it going? And welcome to another edition of Man Up. Today I'm going to be doing my October favorites. It's going to be a little bit late, 2 weeks into November, but whatever, sue me. Anyway, so let's just jump straight into it. My first product that I'm really loving is this Marcel face powder. It is huge. As you guys know, I often rave about my e.l.f. high definition powder. The difference is that the Marcel is really quite larger and boasts probably double the product that there is in this product. What I do love about the e.l.f. though is that the e.l.f. is completely scent free and it's a little bit more white, which I almost kind of like because I use it on the highlights of my face and it gives me a little bit more of a chiseled highlight. But this one has a little bit of a darker tinge. So what I like to do, especially if I'm doing a drag tutorial, is I like to do the lighter color on the highlights and the darker color on the lowlights. So like where I'm going to put my bronzer, I put a little bit here, I put it here in the forehead, I put it on the side of my nose to set that foundation. So it is scented, which I'm not a big fan of, but it boasts a ton of product. And what I really love is that the surface is really huge that the powder is held in. So it's a lot easier for me to put in my lower Mercier brush and really get a ton of product on there. Whereas the space at the top of the e.l.f. is a little bit smaller. Like if you can see the difference, it's not a huge difference, but it really does make a difference if you're trying to get something done quickly. Also, I know like a lot of people do complain that the e.l.f. can be really quite messy. It's because the product is really finely milled, which is great, which is what you want in a finishing powder, but it can get really messy. Like you have to store it with the sponge in the e.l.f. product. If you don't, every time you open it, it's just gonna explode. But I'm now finding that even when I take the sponge out, it just explodes as soon as the sponge comes out. So that's a little bit annoying. Whereas this product, it must have some kind of additive to the talc that kind of allows it to stay a little bit more, I don't wanna say congealed, but it sticks to itself a little bit better. So it doesn't just come flying out everywhere. It's got something in it that kind of weighs it down, which I do like. This is like $15, which it's a ton of product for $15. Mind you, the e.l.f. is $6, so you could get two of the e.l.f.s for the price of this. It's definitely not the best ever, but I am really liking it this month, and I am using it a lot more, especially if I want something a little bit more natural. Since it does have that slight skin tone to it, it does fade into my skin tone a little bit better, and it doesn't really exaggerate the highlights quite as much, so that's nice. My second favorite for October is definitely the e.l.f. High Definition Under Eye Setting Powder. I really, really, really like this. I used it once and I noticed the difference immediately. It was amazing. It really, really does help to set your under eye concealers and under eye primer. No, your under eye primer. It helps to set your under eye primer. Because, you know, that's all you're putting under there. But no, it really helps to seal your under eye concealers and your under eye foundation. So, for that reason, it really does exactly what it's supposed to do. It also has a really light shimmer, which when I first put it on, I'm like, it really turns me off. But I don't know how it does it, but it kind of mutes itself out. The shimmer kind of dissipates. I think it kind of settles in, and it really helps to refract light from the eye and really does help to even further minimize dark circles and fine lines. It's really made a huge difference in my under eye routine. The next product is my Quo sponge. Now this baby, honestly, I did the Sonia Kashuk comparison video, and the more I use this product, the more I realize Sonia Kashuk's sponge is actually complete garbage. Like this sponge blows the Sonia Kashuk sponge out of the water. And I recently had the opportunity to try the Beauty Blender. A friend of mine has one and I just borrowed it to see what all the hubbub was about. And it is an amazing product, but I have to say that this product is easily the perfect dupe. It does exactly what the Beauty Blender does. It's just a different shape. So a lot of the people with the Beauty Blender like to roll it on their face to apply the product. You can't really do that with this sponge, but to be honest, I would never use the sponge in that way anyway. You guys have seen my kind of cream liquid contour tutorial. And in that video, I take a e.l.f. small stipple brush and I just kind of buff out all the contour. And I put a little bit of foundation on here and I buff out the contour. this one, I love it. It works really well. It's probably one of my favorite foundation brushes of all time. But this literally takes that whole process and cuts it by two-thirds. Like, I put on my dark foundation first, then I put on my light foundation. I just use my MAC Face and Body, which I store in the fridge. By the way, if you have MAC Face and Body, it can actually expire pretty quickly, so I actually store it in the fridge. What it does is, one, it helps to thicken up the MAC Face and Body, so it actually has a little bit creamier, denser texture, which I really like for the application process, and it also makes it cooler, so it goes on cold, which kind of helps to minimize pores and also helps to stop irritation or redness. It's really great. That's what I do with this product. I don't do it with my normal foundations, because they're already quite thick, so to make them even thicker would be, I don't even think I'd be able to use them. But since this product is so thin, it really lends to being cold really well. So, random tip on the side. Anyway, back to the sponge. I just put a little bit of MAC Face and Body on the sponge, and I literally just, I just do this on my face, and the contour is done. Let me know in the comments below if you want to see my new updated full face contour. It's awesome. If you haven't gotten it already, it is like $3-4 at the drugstore. Honestly, if you don't have it already, you are missing out. I've got this product too. This one is one that I've had for a long time, and I've never shouted it out before. You've seen me use it a lot, but I've never really singled it out, and it's the Laura Mercier Powder Puff. Now, you're probably thinking, like, you can just get a powder. Most powder puffs come free with a product. Like, I don't get it. But most of those products have, like, little hairs, and they absorb a lot of product. And also, they tend to get really dirty, and then you kind of have to throw them out. Whereas this product, it's really dirty right now. but you can just throw it in the washer machine, wash it, and then reuse it. So this product I've had for almost a year now, and it's still got the same texture, it's still strong, it's still easily used, and I really love the little handle for sneaking your hand in and tucking it and then getting that roll-on effect. It's really, really amazing, and it's definitely worth the money because it's gonna last you so long, and you get to clean it and reuse it, and oh my god, girl, just get the fucking sponge. Last but not least is my KMS California Hair Play Dry Wax. Now, what I love about this product is, I like to do my big hair, I like lots of volume. I have never been able to find a product that applies as light as this one does, but gives me the hold that I need. So what I usually find is that if I use a hair paste or a dry wax in a tube or anything like that, it ends up really weighing my hair down and I can't get that lift that I want. Whereas when I use this, it's an aerosol dry spray. So I just literally squeeze a nozzle and I just spray it into my hair. And it really gives me full holds immediately without weighing down my hair. So then I spray a little bit in as I style it, it holds its place, then I just go in with hairspray. And again, it cuts the entire process of me doing my hair by a half. Because when I'm doing a gel, it really does weigh it down, so I have to go and I have to back comb, I have to do a lot more to get the volume that I'm looking for. Whereas this one, I literally like blow dry upside down, spray this baby in, style it up a bit, and then hairspray, it really cuts the process down. So definitely worth a try. It's not cheap at all. It's actually pretty expensive, so I don't use it very often. I only use it if I'm filming or if I'm going out and doing something. If I really care about what I look like, if I'm just going to do grocery shopping, I just put it in a little bun and I don't really care. But this product does. I've never been able to find a product that does what this product does the way that this product does it, as effectively as this product does it. So definitely worth a try if you love lots of volume. And if you want your hair to stick like a statue and not move all day, like me. Okay, well, thanks so much for watching. And like I said in my last video, I really want to do another Q&A, but I really want to get questions from you guys, whether it be personal or business, or whether it be about makeup and beauty. Let me know in the comments below. I'd really like to do another 20 questions, but with 20 questions that answer questions you have, as opposed to just reading off questions that are on the internet. And like always, thanks so much for watching, and please do like my video if you liked it, if it entertained you, and please do share this on Facebook and on Twitter and on any social media platforms you might have. I really, really do appreciate it. Okay, well, thanks so much for watching, and talk to you later, bros and hoes.